Hey guys, welcome to Compass Kids Online. My name is Frank. I'm our online children's pastor. I hope you guys are ready for an awesome service for you guys. You guys ready? Okay, so we're gonna do worship a couple of seconds. We're gonna have an awesome lesson, and then we're going to do some more worship. So make sure you guys get ready because our service is starting right now.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let her receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room, and heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and heaven and nature. Glory to the King.
Brandon, grab some swim trunks and meet me outside for some fun in the sun. Oh boy.
Hey, Brandon. Come on over here. I just threw some hot dogs on the grill.
John, what are you doing?
Well, we've been cooped up inside for so long, I thought we might as well come out here and take advantage of the beautiful weather.
It's like 12 degrees.
Temperature is a construct.
Okay, seriously, John, what is your plan here?
Yeah, you've heard of Christmas in July, right? Well, I wanted to do July, Christmas.
Yeah, that makes no sense.
Pour yourself some lemonade.
All right. It's frozen.
Yeah, it's summer. It's frozen lemonade.
You're the one who's going to be frozen if you don't get out of here. Come on. All right, let me get you a coat at least, okay? Here you go, buddy.
I feel great. You're strong, Brandon. You'll work out.
I warn you.
John.
And welcome to
The So and So Show. Hey, Christmas Day is just a few days away, and we wanted to wish you a very Merry Christmas from all of us here at the show.
Hey, John, what's one of your favorite Christmas traditions?
The lighting of the Yule log.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That didn't turn out so well for you last year. What are you doing, John?
Hey, Brandon. Hey. Longbeard Carl cut this limb down, and I thought I'd use it for the annual Yule log. Oh.
But you don't have a fireplace.
Fireplace. Oh, hey. Hey, Brandon, hold on a second. Hey! Brandon, there's a squirrel back here!
What is your whole family? Hey, cute little squirrel family. How you doing there in the tree? Hey, hey, you.
No, no. No, stay back. No. Oh, no! Oh! No! No, no! It burns! Ah, get it off! Get it off! It's on my eyes! Ah! Ah! Oh, no! Yeah, I forgot all about that.
Squirrel!
Where?
One of my favorite Christmas traditions is the Christmas card, but we decided this year we were going to do living Christmas cards, so let's see what we got.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, here's one from Longbeard Carl.
Longbeard Carl!
Oh, this should be interesting.
It should be fun. Festive.
Yeah. Let's see what else we got.
Okay.
Here's one from the So and So Show player.
Oh.
Hey. Oh.
Oh, Christmas tree. Oh, Christmas tree. Thy leaves are so unchanging. Oh, Christmas tree. Oh, Christmas tree. Thy leaves are so unchanging. Not only green when summer's here, but also when it's cold and drear. Oh, Christmas tree! Thy leaves are so unchanging.
So moving.
Oh, hey, you know, another one of my favorite things to do at Christmas is to reach out to the people I love and tell them I am thankful for them.
All right, let's call some people.
Okay, here you go.
Me, you want me to do it?
Pull up my contact list. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Got it.
And just scroll through it.
Oh, I see what we're doing. Okay.
Hey, I'm having trouble putting this on my face.
You got it? Scrolling.
Yeah, here we go. Yeah.
Scrolling.
Yeah. Okay,
scrolling.
And stop.
Great. You are now calling a random person.
Okay. Oh, no.
What?
Hello?
It's Sugar Tilt-A-Whirl.
The cotton candy lady?
Yes.
Yikes.
Hello, Sugar.
Wow. If it isn't Brandon and the one with the hat.
It's John.
I know.
Are you still in the cotton candy business, Sugar?
You ever been to a carnival in December?
I haven't.
Eat a lot of cotton candy around the Yule log, do ya?
No, but I thought...
Business is slow, is what I'm saying.
We're so sorry.
What are you sorry for? It's not your business. Your business is sitting there and talking. You can do that year-round.
Oh, okay. Well, I just wanted to
I've launched a new business for Christmas.
What is your business?
Everyone loves singing telegrams, right?
Sure they do.
No, they don't, John. Everyone hates singing telegrams. They're obnoxious and invasive.
Okay.
So, I came up with a new kind of telegram just in time for the holidays. Wanna buy one?
Sure, I'll take one.
That'll be $12.99. I accept Venmo, PayPal, Cash App, Ethereum.
Oh, okay. All right, there.
Thanks.
Come in.
whack you for your purchase of Sugar Tilt-A-Whirl's Screaming Yellowgram! Why sing when you can yell? Dear Brandon and the other one, I hope your Christmas is filled with good tidings and silent nights. Stop. I hope you get everything you wished for, unless you wished for cotton candy, because I'm not doing that right now. We talked about this. Stop. Happy Christmas to you both. You are the only friends I have. Stop. God bless us, everyone.
I don't know what I was expecting, but it wasn't that.
Huh?
But here's something we should all expect.
Huh?
It's Bible story time with Kellen!
Stop.
What is up, good people?
Just getting our Christmas cheer on.
I like it.
Hey, Kellen, what's one of your favorite Christmas traditions?
Oh, I am a huge fan of giving gifts.
Oh, I love getting gifts.
I think he said giving.
Right.
Oh, don't get me wrong. I love getting a good gift, but there's really something special about finding that unexpected surprise to give someone you love.
It's really cool.
I also love telling today's Bible story every year. So let's take a look at the book of Luke and the unexpected surprise that God gave to the world. Lights? It happened like this. Caesar Augustus made a law, a decree, a census would be taken, which meant everyone in the Roman world would be counted.
Hear ye, hear ye. I, Caesar, declare, no, I decree, everyone in the Roman world is to be counted. You must return to your hometown to be listed, and so, it has been said, and so it will be so.
Joseph was engaged to Mary, who was pregnant and about to give birth. When he heard the emperor's decree, he knew he had to travel to his hometown. And so, Joseph and Mary began their journey from Nazareth to Bethlehem, the town of David. The journey probably took them several days. So think about that next time you want to complain about driving a few hours to visit your grandparents. When Mary and Joseph arrived in Bethlehem, there was no place for them to stay.
Hey, we need a place to stay for the night.
Sorry, guest rooms are all full.
Please, Mary is about to have a baby.
Isn't there anything you can do?
Not unless you want to sleep over there.
We'll take it.
So Mary and Joseph stayed near the animals, in a cave or a stable of some kind. While they were there, Mary gave birth to a baby boy. There was no bed, so Mary wrapped the baby in large strips of cloth and placed him in the manger. The manger was a feeding trough for animals. The baby, of course, would be called Jesus, and he was the Son of God, and he would one day become the Savior of the world, a very humble and unexpected gift on that first Christmas, the best present any of us could ever ask for. And that is the Christmas story.
Wow.
Yeah, that was great.
Right? I love this story. There's so much going on at Christmas, getting gifts and going to parties, seeing family and friends, Christmas movies, all the really good things. But the Christmas story reminds us that God loves us so much that he sent his son for us. And that's what Christmas is all about.
Merry Christmas, Kellen.
Merry Christmas, fellas. See you later.
Later.
I love that Christmas all started with a gift, God's gift of his son to the world.
Hey, maybe that's why we give gifts for Christmas, to remind everyone of that very first gift.
I think you're right, John.
Ah.
So,
reveal the question!
What are you giving this Christmas?
Yeah, we love to talk about what we're getting for Christmas, but what are you giving? You can give someone your time.
You can give someone something unexpected.
Mm-hmm. Herb-crusted goat cheese.
Uh-huh. Were you expecting it?
No, I was not. Huh. Mm. Mm-hmm.
You can give someone your love with your actions, your words, and that can point people to God who loved them so much he sent us his son.
Yeah.
talk about it with each other, and we'll see you next time on the So-and-So Show. Merry Christmas! Do you want a bite?
I don't.
Jingle bells! Jingle bells! Jingle all the way! Oh, what fun it is to ride open sleigh! Stop. Jingle bells! Jingle bells! Jingle all the way! Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh!
Stop. John, stop before you break the set!
'Worthy of every song we could ever sing, worthy of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, oh, we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you.
Yeah.
Hey guys, wasn't that an awesome service? Let us know, guys, what you thought about it in the comments below. Hey guys, just want to tell you guys, next week we're going to be launching our brand new Compass Kids service here. It's going to be awesome. I got a lot of friends that are going to be helping me out. We got a new set that won't look like this. It's going to be amazing, all right, guys? So make sure you guys are here. So the service might be a little bit longer, but we're going to have so much fun. We're going to have games. We're going to have worship. We're going to have so much fun. And also, it's going to be our first weekend where we're going to be just online. So then online for the main service and online for kids. So make sure you guys are here on our YouTube channel checking this out. Make sure you subscribe. You can push that bell icon to get the notification to know when we post anything, because we've got some awesome stuff that we're working on. All right, guys. See you later.